Hey teachers, what are you guys doing?
Sorry, didn't see you there. Teacher Minisha and I, we're just enjoying this well-deserved break here after supporting students, you know, this academic year. We're enjoying a cup of English tea.
Yes, at the same time, we've also got exciting news to share with all viewers. Now, we've been receiving positive feedback from parents that you love our monthly video content, which is why we've decided to rebrand the video series to English Tea with Teacher Mingxuan and Teacher Derek.
Why English Tea, you may ask? Well, it's a pun on the phrase. One can easily associate the English Tea subject with the drink, English Tea, because, well, both contain the word English.
That's correct. Also, the term tea is internet lingo to refer to the latest news and scoop. Don't believe when asked a child. So you can continue to expect from us to share with you the latest updates on the MOE English syllabus, as well as useful tips and strategies that you can apply to help your child achieve English mastery.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss out on the latest content from us. Without further ado, let's get to today's content.
Hey parents, do you know what time of the year it is?
It's the holiday!
Yes, indeed. Now, as you can see, it's not just the students who are excited, but the teachers as well.
Yep, students and parents who are familiar with me will know that I'm a big advocate for playing hard after having worked hard.
Hey, but Teacher Derek, so what about the academics? Right? Parents will be worried that their child will have too much free time with nothing to do.
Exactly, which is why in this video, Teacher Mingxuan and I will be sharing with you three fun activities that your child can do to improve their English language mastery this school holiday. And better still, you can join in and have fun with your children at the same time.
At number three, we have watching movies with subtitles on. Now, when your child performs this simple step, there are actually multiple benefits. Firstly, they'll be subconsciously learning the correct sentence structures that writers use. This is especially true when watching movies in foreign languages.
Yep, when your child has resort to reading the subtitles, they're actually internalizing and reading English sentences. This will of course help them to construct better sentences for paper one writing. Not only that, as your child listens to the movie while reading the subtitles, this action also increases their ability to map sounds with word recognition, thereby improving their spelling and reading fluency.
Your child will also come across new words to add to their vocabulary bank. Just be sure that they check the meaning of these new words and apply them correctly. All these benefits are supported by education research.
And number two, we have reading a book every month. Parents, I know it can be a real challenge to get your child to start reading. Especially with them being exposed to the various forms of entertainment nowadays, it's easy for your child to get distracted. However, it's really important for them to understand the benefits that reading can bring. And the trick that we've seen work with many students is to get them started on something that interests them.
At EduEdge, we have the saying which is to respect the reader's choice. This means that if your child is interested in a book about gaming, then they should start from there. After all, reading something is still better than not reading at all.
Yep.
At the start, it's more important to simply get your child to read rather than focus on what they are reading.
Of course, if your child is really comfortable with reading, then that's even better. We could get them started on some novels which are easy to digest. Now here's a little treat for Teacher Mingxuan and myself. We've compiled a short list of novels to get your child started. Now these are the same novels that Teacher Mingxuan and I read when we were younger, and they have helped us develop our language skills over time. Here you go.
Finally, if the above titles are not your child's cup of tea, or if your child is a little younger, then you could consider getting them started on comic books. One of the benefits of comic books is that they can be more fun and easier to read than regular books, as they offer graphics and illustrations. This can be more appealing to children who have not yet developed much interest in reading. Comics from the popular Marvel and DC series will be great places to start.
Alright, now our last tip for today is playing word games like Scrabble and Charades. Scrabble is just one of the many games you can play with your kids to help them learn while having a bit of fun. Now, many students often struggle to find the right words to use in their writing due to their limited vocabulary. Thus, when your child plays Scrabble, they're actually having an English lesson without even realizing it. This activity enriches your child's vocabulary as they learn new words to deposit to their vocabulary bank. And the more words there are in this vocabulary bank, the easier it is for them to make a withdrawal when they need to find the right word while writing.
To maximize learning, do have a Scrabble dictionary ready on hand for all players to refer to. At the same time, in today's day and age, we do understand that your child will be much more likely to prefer digital games. Well, many of these traditional games have been made available online as well. Here are some of our recommendations for the best education games your child could explore.
And that's it for this video. We're really glad you stayed all the way.
Now, if you have found great value watching this video, do remember to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel so that you'll receive the latest content from us.
That's right, and see you soon in the next English Tea series.